Hello friends, in this video we are going to see about chickenpox, which is also called as varicella. It is caused by a virus named varicella zoster virus. Varicella zoster virus causes chickenpox as well as herpes zoster. So in this varicella zoster virus, it is characterized by a vesicular rash accompanied by a fever and malaise. This is the difference between chickenpox and smallpox. Here the vesicular rash, which is accompanied by fever and malaise. In smallpox, first the fever arises, which is followed by a third day vesicular rash. Okay, this is the differencing feature. Then smallpox and herpes zoster, which is caused by the same organism, as I already mentioned. Now we are going to see about the burden of chickenpox. Burden of chickenpox includes globally 4.2 million cases has been hospitalized due to this chickenpox, and 4,200 deaths has occurred in this chickenpox infection. Factors which is necessary for the severity of the disease and outcome in a patient. Mainly infants, pregnant women and immunocompromised patients, which includes mainly HIV. These are the factors which leads to the severity of the disease and outcome in the patient is more severe with the illness. Now we are going to see about herpes zoster disease. Herpes zoster disease is nothing but a secondary infection. In this, it mainly increases with age. Markedly increases after 50 years of age. This is more important. Markedly after 50 years of age, this disease is more common. Here, Kerala is reported with the maximum number of cases, whereas West Bengal reported with the maximum number of deaths due to this disease. Now, epidemiological factors. In epidemiological factors, the agent, the varicella zoster virus, comes under the family of human herpes virus 3, that is human alpha herpes virus 3. It primarily causes chickenpox. Latent infection. Latent infection mainly stays in the cranial nerves, sensory ganglion, spinal dorsal root ganglion. As we have seen that the latent infection, which is mainly due to the immunocompromised patients. Immunocompromised patients means immunosuppressive therapy. While they are taking that immunosuppressive therapy, the cell mediated immunity may be decreased, or the cell mediated immunity naturally wanes with the increased age. In both of these cases, the latent infection, which is present either in the sensory ganglion or spinal dorsal root ganglion or in the cranial nerves, may come back and cause a secondary infection, which is called as herpes zoster. This occurs in 10-30% of the patients infected with the chickenpox. Here the painful vesicular rashes then turns into a pustular eruption in one or more sensory nerve. This is seen in this case. If the infection occurs during the pregnancy in the mother, during the first trimester, that is during the 20 weeks, then the baby has a more probability of getting congenital varicella. The infants have a higher risk of herpes zoster in the first year. So if the mother has the infection of chickenpox during pregnancy, then the infants have a higher risk of developing herpes zoster in the first year. Now we are going to see about the environmental factors. Environmental factors, the peak incidence is during this winter and spring season, and mostly during the coolest and dry months in tropical regions. The virus is heat level, and outside the host cell, it can survive for only few hours and to a maximum of 1 to 2 days. Then it is mostly inactivated by lipids, detergents and proteases. So cleaning the surfaces using this lipids, detergents and proteases decreases the spread of infection. And during the chickenpox infection, cleaning the houses and their products which is used by the infected people prevents the spread of the infection to the household mates. Now the transmission. Transmission is mainly through the droplet infection and the droplet nuclei. The entry of virus is through the upper respiratory tract and through the conjunctiva. So you have to see here the route of entry into the body is through the upper respiratory tract or conjunctiva. It can also spread through the contact infection through the fomites. As I already said, the infection can spread through the fomites easily. You have to keep them separated from other household members to prevent infection. Virus can cross the placental barrier and infect the fetus, leading to congenital varicella, which we already see in the pregnant ladies. Though the incubation period varies from 14 to 16 days or 10 to 21 days. It can either vary from 14 to 16 days or 10 to 21 days, which is the longest. Now we enter into the clinical features. Clinical features can be classified into two stages, pre-eruptive stage and eruptive stage. Pre-eruptive stage is the stage before the eruption of the rashes, and the eruptive stage is the stage where the rashes appear. Here in the pre-eruptive stage, there would be sudden, mild or moderate fever. The eruption would be sudden and there would be mild or moderate fever. The pre-eruptive stage, there would be mild or moderate fever. Then along with that, back pain, shivering, malaise would be present. It lasts for 24 hours. For adults, severe and 2 to 3 days before rash comes out. Because this pre-eruptive stage is normally for 24 hours in children, in adults, the stage would be very severe and it would occur 2 to 3 days before rash comes out. Normally, in children, this rash and fever occurs simultaneously. So, which is the main difference between the smallpox and chickenpox. But in case of adults, it can appear 2 to 3 days before the rash comes out, similar to that of the smallpox. Now, the second stage is called as the eruptive stage. In the eruptive stage, rash is the first sign, which starts at the day of the fever. As I said, rashes and the fever starts at the same day in chickenpox. Distribution of the rash.
rash is distributed symmetrically on both sides of the body. The rash is symmetrical. It starts from the face, arms and legs. No, it starts from the trunk, then goes into the face, arms and legs. In trunk, it is more abundant. Now here, mucosal surface and axilla is affected. Whereas in smallpox, mucosal surface and axilla is not affected. But palms and soles are affected in chickenpox. Here, palms and soles are not affected. Axilla and mucosal surface are involved in chickenpox. And these are the differences between smallpox and chickenpox. Then, rapid evolution. Rapid evolution here, first we said that the rash can pass through many stages, and these are the following stages: macule, papule, vesicle and swab. Here there would be a dew drops appearance as the vesicles are filled with fluid. As vesicles are filled with fluid, this appears as a dew drops. These vesicles are usually superficial, easily ruptured walls and surrounded by areas of inflammation. The vesicles are superficial, easily ruptured walls, and there would be area of inflammation surrounding that vesicles. It is not umbilicated. The vesicles are usually not umbilicated, but the vesicles form crust without pustular stage. In certain conditions, the vesicles can form crust without passing through this pustular stage. The third feature is that of the pleomorphism. Pleomorphism is a specific and important feature of chickenpox. Here, all stages of the rash can be seen at one time in the same area because the rash progresses and new rashes also appear in the same area. So you can see all these stages. What stages? Macules, papules, rashes, that's vesicles and swab. All these stages you can see in the same area at a particular time. This is known as pleomorphism. This is a feature of chickenpox. Here, rashes appear in successive crops for 4 to 5 days. This is the reason for simultaneous appearance of all stages of rashes in the same area. Now we are going to see about the complications of the chickenpox. Complications, it is more important here. In uncomplicated cases, mortality rate is very less. That is less than 1% of cases. As we have already said, in immunocompromised patients, the chickenpox can easily affect them. In them, there are many complications. We can learn with the mnemonic here: P. H for hemorrhages, that is varicella hemorrhages. E for encephalitis, here I have written here encephalitis. Then A for acute cerebellar ataxia. R for Reye syndrome. Reye syndrome means acute encephalopathy with fatty degeneration of liver. Reye syndrome is one of the different syndrome caused in the complication of chickenpox. And then for P, pneumonia. This is for immunocompromised and immunosuppressed patients. These are the complications. In case of this varicella pneumonia, as I said, pneumonia during this varicella, here it is most common in adults, neonates and immunocompromised patients, but it is rare in children. Children, it is the very rare phenomenon. Now, maternal varicella. Maternal varicella, as we already seen, if the mother attains that varicella, the baby would get herpes zoster during that first year. If mother has varicella, there would be fetal wastage and birth defects. There is a low birth weight, cutaneous scars, atrophied limbs and microcephaly. This can be seen, and with that, along with that, the following features can also be seen. Cataract can be seen in the baby infant, then microophthalmia, chorioretinitis, deafness and cerebrocortical atrophy. These are all the features in which the maternal varicella occurs in the mother. If the mother acquires this chickenpox within 5 days of delivery, then mother gets varicella, and the newborn is at the highest risk of getting this disseminated disease. So to prevent this, varicella zoster immunoglobulin is given to the baby. Then the virus has the potential for oncogenicity. It has the potential to develop cancers. Then varicella zoster virus is the major virus which is associated with this two optic diseases, that is acute retinal necrosis and progressive outer retinal necrosis. This acute retinal necrosis and progressive outer retinal necrosis is most common in HIV patients. HIV patients, the immune is very much suppressed and they can easily get these two associated complications. There are secondary bacterial infections. Here we have seen the viral complications and bacterial infections, which mainly includes the GABS, that is group A beta hemolytic streptococcus infection and staphylococcus aureus. These are the secondary bacterial infection associated with this. Following that, other small complications, and in children it is associated with leukemia. Okay, these are the other complications, which is not much important, but it is rarely occurring in the patients. Following that, in immunocompromised patients, immunocompromised individuals means what are the conditions which are included in this immunocompromised individuals. Here, malignancies, organ transplant patients, HIV, and one who are taking high dose of corticosteroids come under this immunocompromised individuals. The rare complication, but which is a fatal complication, is disseminated intravascular coagulation, which is the fatal complication. And in children with leukemia are prone to develop severe disseminated varicella disease. That is, you can see in children with leukemia, a rare complication occurs, which is severe disseminated varicella zoster virus disease. So with this, we finish this video. In the next video, we'll see about the laboratory diagnosis, treatment and the vaccination which is given for the chickenpox. So also see that video, subscribe to the channel for regular videos. Thank you.